Good morning. So we're heading out to the river today. We're going to Tailem Bend.
Tailem Bend.
Which is near like Murray Bridge, I think.
Sort of, yeah. Kind of.
Anyway, that direction.
I suck at geography.
So yeah, I've got the jet ski in the boat.
Yeah.
Yeah, all packed up. Taking two cars so we can tow them, obviously. Tully's going to tow the jet ski.
We might not make it.
Not die. Fear for our we lives. Ash shotgun the front, so she has the best brace position.
I'll be careful.
So yeah, it's what, like an hour?
An hour and a half, yeah.
Got some nice cabins there that we're going to stay in, and yeah, it should be pretty good weather. Pretty warm, I think.
Yeah, it's meant to be around 30, I think.
Yeah, perfect. Alright, we're all ready to go to the river. Okay, see you, Tully.
I'm trying to find your breakfast.
This is our little cabin apartment. We're staying at Murrayview Park. And there's four of them here. Really nice. Got full kitchen. Bedroom number one. Bedroom number two. Perfect. Morning guys, day two down the river at Tailem Bend. We had a very good day yesterday. We started off pretty early down at the river, kind of set up the gazebos and chairs and everything, and had the boat and jet skis in the water, so yeah.
Absolutely freezing.
Yeah, in the morning it was. Yeah,
we were dying.
We had jumpers on, we were like sitting in the sun to like warm up.
Which was clearly a bad idea.
We did put sunscreen on, but I guess the water probably washed it off once we... Mm. Anyway, we did not apply enough because we got burnt.
Some more than others.
But yeah, once it did warm up, it was really nice. And we ended up sitting in the shade, obviously, because it got too hot, and to protect ourselves from the sun. But yeah, in and out of the water all day, which is good. Ash and I, it was our first time kneeboarding and wakeboarding.
Mm-hmm. Some did better than others. Still be good at first go. And I was just face planting every single time.
But you got up on both of them, especially kneeboarding, you did well.
Kneeboarding was okay. I feel like you definitely showed me up. So I face planted quite a few times, like literally in the water, which was great. And then it gets to your turn and she's just like, oh yeah, no worries. Puts the knee strap on and cruising along. It's fine. No worries.
But I've water skied and stuff before.
Yeah, I've never done any of that.
Yeah, exactly.
Stuff. I'm also generally uncoordinated.
You did well though. Each time you definitely got better. Like, it's just stayed up for longer. Yeah, but even that, like at the start, it was like straight away numb. But then, like at the end, you got up and like each time was definitely better.
Just again, takes this practice. One over here, face planted maybe once or twice, and then she's just cruising along, no worries, having a good time. She's like, oh, I'm ready to get off now.
My arms are getting sore.
You're like, oh, I don't need to get off, but I can. It's fine.
It's quite the workout. Kind of sore today. My back and my butt's kind of sore.
My abs are a bit sore.
My arms a little bit.
My sunburn's sore.
Mm. So we'll probably do the same again today. Probably go on the tubes and the biscuits and that for a bit. And yeah, come back up, make some lunch. It's good because it's literally just walking distance.
Yeah.
We had a barbecue last night, I think we'll do that again tonight, and yeah, looking forward to it. So yeah, should be good.
I can't wait to see your face part, Nanny.
I'll have the camera out.
When I was on it.
pay $15 entry, and then you get access to the cube, which comes with a complimentary wine tasting, and you get to go experience the whole thing. So we finished up at Darrenburg. It was really cool. There's heaps to do apart from the actual wine tasting as well, which is really fun. Walk through all the museum and all the quirky stuff that they've got there. So we've head back to the Airbnb now, and we've just plugged in the PlayStation 1, which is crazy. But yeah, for a game to be $79 back then, in terms of how much it'd be worth now with inflation, is like crazy. So we put in now, it's very pixelated. Pretty keen to give it a try though.
The 21st century is an international industry. Money and expertise flow freely through the global computer nets, and every type of weapon imaginable is available on the black market of the third world.
Good morning, guys. Day two at McLaren Vale. It's really beautiful out here, and I can't believe how close it is to the city.
Like, yeah. We thought it would be, like, way more spread out and, yeah. like, just kind of, like, nothing for ages, and then, like, a winery, then nothing, then a winery. But it actually has, like, a really good main street. There's, like, a supermarket. There's a Mitre 10 randomly.
And there's wineries like on the main street. Like,
yeah.
It's kind of weird, but
you
it's
could
good.
Probably walk to.
Yeah.
Not from here because we're like kind of right up on the hill, which has got an awesome view.
Yeah. Our Airbnb is really nice.
Yeah. It's such a funky vibe. Yeah. Like when we got here, we were just finding all these new things to look at.
And I know. You think you've seen everything and then you're like, oh, look at this. And then like look inside it and there's just like quirky, unique things everywhere. It's really cool.
It's so cool. And the bird who owns it. is a like a massage like a Reiki master and does Ayurvedic massage, which is kind of cool, which we tried to book, but she's booked out, so she obviously must be pretty good.
Yeah, she actually does like in-house, so she can come here and do it for you,
like that service,
which is really cool. Yeah, so we just made our morning coffee. There's a coffee machine in here with some pods, so we've done that. Pretty good actually.
The milk makes it.
Yeah, so they left for us to use like new like milk, butter, wine, chocolates, and it's all local and like South Australian, which is really cool. And I love that, supporting local brands and Australian made, so that's awesome. So Tully's just gone home for a little bit to grab a couple of things, and then when she gets back, we're gonna get ready and head out to some more wineries today. We only did Darrenburg yesterday.
I think we're all a bit tired. Yeah.
And by the time we finished there, it was like 4 o'clock anyway. Most of them shot at like 5 or 5:30. So
it was kind of fun to hang out at the Airbnb though.
We
played
football
games and
nice and relaxing.
Tried to play the PlayStation 1.
Yeah. It was a bit of a fail. Like we did. The racing one wasn't too bad.
It looked terrible.
It was just like so touchy and like the graphics are so bad, but I kind of loved it.
It was pretty funny.
Tried a shooting game as well, but that was an absolute fail.
There's like even like little like word search like books and stuff, so these two were trying and failing at PS1. So I just sat there with a little word search.
And then we played Scrabble.
That was so fun.
Yeah, so we head out to a few wineries today. Gonna go to a gin distillery as well, and then grab some lunch and go out for dinner because it's our last night here, unfortunately.
No,
the week's gone
quick.
Super quick, yeah. But it's been amazing, like such a good trip. And I love that we've kind of done three different things and like broken it up.
Because usually we just stay at the beach.
Yeah.
Which is still awesome.
Yeah.
Like we love it there.
And we booked our return trip, as we said in our other vlog, back in August. But that's a pretty short one. It'll be like 4 days, 3 days.
Yeah,
days.
Just for the week. Is it Thursday to Sunday?
I don't know.
I can't remember what I booked. Yeah.
But it was $55 return with Jetstar sales. So that was absolutely crazy. So looking forward to these wineries. Should be a good day out. It'd be nice to get dressed up again and get drunk.
Get drunk!
Nah, I'm not even a big fan of wine, so I'll be like,
that's
the
why
gin
we
place?
Need to go to the distillery.
Yeah.
That's, you'll just be knocking them back. Yesterday at Darrenburg, when Tully and I are just, you know, having a bit of a sniff. We both, I like wine, but she loves wine. We're having a bit of a sniff, a bit of a swirl, and Snippy's like, just down it, knock it back. It's like, okay, no
Well,
worries.
I don't really care about the taste. Like, I'm not a fan of wine, so I'm just like,
Could but then appreciate. I was
pouring a lot in the bucket, the tip-out bucket that you don't like, so mine was pretty full.
And that bird, she thought that I was serious when I said, let's just drink the thing at the end. She's like, there's chips in there. And I was like,
She's like, that's where you put your stuff that you don't like. And we're like, we know. Ash was like, yeah, let's do King's Cart with all the mixed drinks that we've thrown out. So we'll finish off these coffees and get ready for the wineries, and we'll see you then. So we're all ready to go to our wineries. It's what, like 11:30 probably?
Yeah, nearly.
Yeah. So first up, we're going to go to Tintara.
Yeah.
Yeah. Which is in town, and grab some light lunch as well, and then go to
the one out of
down
town.
The rabbit hole.
Down the rabbit hole, that's the one.
Yeah. And then we're going to go to Fox Creek Wines, and they also have like a distillery there, I'm pretty sure, as well, where you can do gin tastings. So yeah, we'll get some food there as well. And then the last one will probably be Never Never, which is a gin distillery as well. So probably...
It's also just up the road.
Yeah. That should take us, I think, pretty much all day till about 5 o'clock or whenever they shut. And then probably come back and, oh, we'll go out and get some dinner. Probably down the street somewhere. So... yeah, it should be good.
So we're at Tintara. We're doing a bit of a tasting. We opted for the alternate varietals flight, which is mostly reds, but we've got a Prosecco, and they put in like a mystery wine, which was kind of cool. It's $10 to do, and you get 5 tastings. They're all kind of really different, and they come out and explain what each one is to you. And they've got like a little laminated card that they... explain what's in them and what kind of flavors they should have,
and the pricing
per bottle.
What do you think, Tully? How were they?
Yeah, there were some good ones in there. I think the Prosecco and the mystery wine was my favorite, and it's definitely been a nicer experience this time around. I've come here before, which was fine, but sitting outside and the sun's out,
and being
with you guys,
it's really nice. Yeah, like all the grounds and everything, and
yeah
so we had a nice lunch at Tin Shed, really good food, and now we've just come out to Down the Rabbit Hole Winery, and it looks really cute so far. They've got like an old bus here and stuff, so yeah, keen to see it.